Right now I want to talk about a function that was added to our metal detectors about a year ago called photo eye sync. That's when you've got a product that's, so this product here is about 180 millimeters long. Now if you go to a metal detector and just go into the product settings, you can see here there is the default setting for fail behavior. You can see this fail behavior. The default setting is immediate. So basically what that means is that the moment it detects the metal, whether it's at the beginning of the pack or the end of the pack, that's when it will send the signal. And that's to your rejector or to a check wire if you've got a combination system. If you're just stopping the metal detector, this probably doesn't really matter so much. But if you've got another device like a rejector that relies on timing settings, it's really important. If you've got quite a long product, if the pack was let's say 300 millimeters or 400 millimeters long, the time difference between when it detects it, if it's at the beginning of the pack compared to the end, could be as much as half a second to a second. So that will totally mess with your output timings for the subsequent device. Now the feature that they added recently is in this menu in fail behavior, you can now choose photo eye synchronization. PES Sync is the description that they've used for it. So PES Sync means that no matter where the contaminant is in the pack, it could be beginning, middle, end, the photo eye, if you come around here, Alex, you can see there's a photo eye on the metal detector, just the same as there is on the check wire. Now what it means is that the software, once it's registered a detection, all the timings will relate to the photo eye being broken by the leading edge of the packet. So what it means downstream is you will get consistent timing, basically, no matter where the contaminant is. So what I'm going to show you now, if you come to this screen on the check wire, which I've showed in other videos, there's a timing indicator here to say when the timing was received. Now I'm putting, firstly, the pack through with the contaminant at the beginning, and you can see it's around 0.7 of a second since the detection to actually telling the check wire to receive its input. I'm now going to put the pack around the other way. Now based on these speeds, it's about 0.2 of a second. The distance between here and here translates to about 0.2 of a second in time based on these speeds we're running at the moment. So now what I'd expect with photo eye sync active, you can still see it doesn't matter. It's exactly the same, 0.7, 0.68 to 0.7. Now if I go and change this back to the default, which is immediate, we'll see a total difference here. So I'm going to put it through with the contaminant at the back of the pack. So you'll see here now the reading says 0.43. Now if I put it through with the contaminant at the beginning of the pack, it'll give us a different reading, 0.12. So you can see that's about a 0.3 second difference, which represents this pack traveling at about 30 meters a minute. That's about 0.3 of a second. But when it comes to synchronizing your inputs and outputs and your rejector, that's really important to understand. So obviously we have no control over where a contaminant is going to appear in a pack. So if your packs are longer, on the longer side, then it's probably really important to activate that feature of photo eye synchronization when you're programming your metal detector and your check wire. Thanks for watching.